The five mandatory daily prayers for Muslims are as follows. Fajr prayer, from dawn to right before sunrise. Dhuhr prayer, just after noon, midday, when the sun passes the median point in the sky. Asr prayer, late part of the afternoon, halfway between noon and sunset. Maghrib prayer, directly after sunset. Isha prayer, late evening, dark night, approximately an hour and a half after sunset. The five daily prayers set the rhythm of a Muslim's day. Prayers must be performed at their appointed due times, unless a reasonable excuse exists to delay them. Prayers are prohibited to be delayed to the point that they overlap into the next prayer's time frame. Before the prayer is begun, a Muslim is required to perform ablution, wudu in Arabic, which is the act of cleaning and purifying oneself from any physical bodily fluids such as urine, blood, etc. with water. The ritual of ablution consists of washing one's hand, face, arms, head, and feet. It's important that a Muslim must be clean and free of impurities in his body, clothing, and the area in which the prayer will be performed. One drop of waste matter present anywhere would void one's prayer. In Muslim countries, prayer is publicly announced to the community, not by bells, but rather by an Islamic chant or call of prayer known as Athan in Arabic. Prayer is commenced by standing up facing the direction of Mecca, in present-day Saudi Arabia, where the holy house of God known as the Kaaba is situated. Muslims from all over the globe face the direction in which the first house was built for the worship of the one God. It's important to note that Muslims do not worship the Kaaba, rather Muslims only use the holy house as a direction to face while worshiping the one God, as instructed by God Himself. During prayer, Muslims are directed to disconnect themselves and clear their mind of any worldly matters as they are conversing with God. They pray to God who is near, who is all-loving, all-hearing, all-caring, all-powerful. A Muslim is to concentrate on their words and to humble themselves exclusively to the Almighty. A Muslim affirms that God is the master, that he or she is the servant of God who is in need of the Almighty's direction, help, and guidance to the straight path. The Islamic prayer is so sacred that it is prohibited for one to eat, drink, or hold conversation as they pray. Muslims are commanded to pray in the way that was taught by Prophet Muhammad. The Islamic prayer movements consist of standing, bowing, and prostrating. According to our Prophet, man is closest to God when he is in prostration. The prayer consists of recitations from the Holy Quran, praises of the Almighty, and supplications seeking guidance, forgiveness, and more. An established prayer and give zakah and bow with those who bow in worship and obedience. While not mandated, it is highly encouraged for one to even awaken in the middle of the night to pray to God, as this is a common practice of righteous people. The Islamic prayer is a ritual which has been unchanged for more than 1400 years and is repeated 5 times a day by hundreds of millions of people all around the globe. Earlier prophets and messengers also performed Salah prayer, in which the act of prostration was involved. According to the Gospel of Matthew, Prophet Jesus fell with his face to the ground and prayed. Going a little farther, he fell with his face to the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken from me, yet not as I will, but as you will." Matthew 26:39. It's important to note that God is transcendent, free of all needs, and totally independent. He is in no need of human worship or veneration, as he gains nothing from it. Muslims do not pray or worship God for God's sake. Rather, they worship Him for their own sake. God made worship and the remembrance of God beneficial to mankind, both in this world and in the next. And whoever strives only strives for the benefit of himself. Indeed, Allah is free from need of the worlds. The benefits of praying to the Almighty are vast, and the blessings of prayer are beyond our imagination. Prayer motivates one to do good and strive for the best, so one can live a good life in this world and in the next world eternally. Indeed, I am Allah. There is no deity except me. So worship me and establish prayer for my remembrance. Quran 20:14. Our Prophet narrated, "Whoever guides another to a good deed will get a reward similar to the one who performs it." So please like, subscribe, and share this video. Assalamu alaikum.